Good morning, children. We are moving towards the last part of our first chapter, the last lesson. Yesterday I told you M. Hamel had new copies for all the children that day, and they started writing only two words: France, Alsace, France, Alsace. The children, they were writing these words as if they are writing French literature, and it was so quiet. The only sound heard was the scratching of the pens over the paper. In between, some beetles flew in, but nobody paid any attention to it, not even the littlest ones. And in between, some pigeons cooed, and Franz thought to himself, will the Germans make them sing in German, even the pigeons? While writing, whenever Franz he looked up, he found M. Hamel sitting motionless in his chair and gazing at one thing and then at another, as if he wanted to fix it in his mind. Each and everything he wanted to fix in his mind before leaving that school. He had served 40 years. He had been there in the same place with the beautiful garden outside and the class in front of him. And upstairs, some sound could be heard. His sister, she was packing up the trunks because they had to leave that place the next day. M. Hamel was so sad. He kept control over his emotion. He performed his duties faithfully, and he heard each and every lesson to the last. After writing, they had their lesson in history, and then the children, the babies, they chanted their ba, be, bi, bo, bu, the alphabets. And even the village elders, even the old Hauser, he had put on his spectacles and he was also reciting or chanting it along with the children, holding his primer in both the hands. Seeing that, Franz, he wanted to laugh. At the same time, when he found that he was crying, he wanted to laugh, and at the same time they also cried. And he remembered the last lesson very nicely. And at that time the church clock struck 12. And the Prussian soldiers, they were returning from the drill. And M. Hamel, he wanted to communicate with the children. But something choked him. He got up and he said, I, but he could not complete his words. What did he do? He turned towards the blackboard, took a piece of chalk in his hand, and in very big handwriting, he wrote on the board, Vive la France. Long live France. Then he stopped and leaned against the wall, and without a word and without even turning back, with a gesture, he said, the school is dismissed, you may go. That's the chapter. And here, hope you are ready with your notebooks. You can note down the questions. First question, write it. How did M. Hamel feel and behave during the last lesson? I'll repeat the question. How did M. Hamel feel and behave during the last lesson? You can note down the points. He was very solemn and gentle. He sat motionless in his chair during the writing lessons. He gazed at one thing or the other. Perhaps he wanted to fix in his mind how everything looked in that little school room. Surely it must have broken his heart to leave it all after 40 years of service. Hope you have noted down the points. M. Hamel, he was very solemn, serious and gentle. He sat motionless in his chair. He gazed at one thing or the other as if he wanted to fix up in his mind how everything looked. Is it clear? Next question. Franz, he wanted to laugh and at the same time to cry. Explain. I'll repeat the question. Franz, he wanted to laugh and cry at the same time. Why? Did you note it down? Yes, the answer is, it was so funny to watch the village elders chanting the lessons with the small babies. And they wanted to laugh at that. At the same time, they found tears rolling down his cheeks. And this made them cry. Okay? And now, the last question. Describe the last lesson. That you can write your answer by yourself. Describe the last lesson. We don't want a very lengthy answer, but including the main points, you can write it. And thus, we have come to an end of this chapter, and we'll continue with the next chapter tomorrow. Thank you.